Howdy, 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 folks. This is Ben with Vendors United to Learn, hotdogs.com, hotdogcarstore.com. Hope you're doing good. I am. It is a beautiful sunny day. Finally, it's June, and it looks like summer may be here, finally, here in the mountains. So things are blooming. It's beautiful. Let me pause this real quick. I'm going to share something that was shared with me. Mac Daddy's Dawgz and Catering sent me a video and wanted me to see his setup, did a complete walk around, and then asked, you know, my opinions, advice. I said, hey, do you care if I share this with others? And he said, absolutely, go ahead, share away. So I wanted to share it with you. Let me pull up a better screen maybe so you can see this better. So this is a vendor that is fairly new, and he is set up and he does a walk around for us, and I'm going to stop it at certain points and point out stuff because I have seen it. It's a great video, but I've got some things to point out that are good, and I've got some things that could potentially be better, or I need to explain a little bit. And if you have any questions, please post them in the comments. I thank you for being here, and I hope this helps you. We've had a lot of people kicking butt lately, and it just makes me so freaking happy. Especially when I hear about somebody that's really been struggling. You know, they've lost their jobs back in March, and now they stumbled across a video of mine or somebody told them, and they started vending and changed their lives. Hey, Ken Packer, my good friend, Ken Packer. He's northeast of me up in East Tennessee, up near the Tri-Cities area. So, I'm not sure if that's a heritage cart or not. He's got one of my add-ons, which he explains on there, but, I don't know what company that is. And believe it or not, there's a company that makes a heritage cart, and then there's a company that knocks off me and that other company. Cause I had a lady that is having a nightmare of problems on a heritage cart getting it passed, and it's because she bought the knockoff, from a company in South Carolina. Who knocks other manufacturers off, changes their names just a little bit, and knocks them off. So it's always good to do your due diligence, and that way you don't run into problems. Look at there, 757 Dawgz Pound open Memorial Day. Congratulations, Justin. That's freaking awesome. I'm gonna throw that up there on the screen so everybody can see it. That is freaking awesome. Congratulations. Let's see here. Oh, Dennis Merker just got him a brand new big dog cart. Congratulations, Dennis. You're going to love it. You know, obviously I can have any cart I want. And I just, after years, I'm talking almost 10 years, I traded my cart. I got rid of the one, and I got me another big dog, just because I love the big dog. So let's see. I'm going to play this video. Hopefully the sound comes through. If for any reason there's no sound, please let me know in the comments. I'd like to know so that I can fix it real quick.
All right, guys, this is Art Makepeace here with Mac Daddy's Dawgz and Catering. I wanted to do a quick walkthrough video of my setup here. I'm in the parking lot here at Family Dollar in Garner, North Carolina, which is right next to Raleigh. Got a BP station over there. It's a laundromat in the corner. Today's Saturday, so the bank's closed, but there's a bank.
Okay, I'm playing this. Are y'all? Oh, you can hear. Thanks, Steve. Appreciate that a bunch.
America there. Lots of traffic here on Route 50. So it's pretty good, pretty decent location. All right, start back here. It's my drink cooler. I've got a smaller cooler than most people do, or most other vendors. Mostly because I have a bad shoulder and back, and I can't lift a bigger cooler off the back of my truck. So, but I've got another cooler about the same size in the back of the truck with drinks on ice. So if I run low, I can just grab some more cold ones and throw them in the cooler. Smart. So we're good to go. If you see up front there on the road, I got.
Keep in mind, we have some of the most successful vendors we have just because of their life experience are older vendors. And obviously, not with everybody, but a lot of older vendors have some health problems or health things or the old injuries and arthritis. And we've got vendors in their 70s vending who are, we've got one in VU that's over 80 that vend, and they have to use the lighter coolers and stuff. This was brilliant. It was a good point.
Swooper flag. I got my chair in the shade so I can sit my ass down when it's slow. I got chips today. I've just got regular chips. That's pretty much all I got left, so I'm trying to get rid of them before I buy some more.
All right, I'm going to stop you right there, okay? That's something important. You see the chips hanging. Here's my 2 cent on this, and it's actually worth, it's probably closer to 3 cent. The never hang chips or anything that you don't have a lot of. So if you're going to hang chips, even if you make your own chip clip, stringer, and there's lots of video tutorials on how to do that, or you can just buy them. But if you're going to hang them, hang a lot of them. Make it look busy, full, because when people see a few things there, it almost looks sparse, so they think you're down, you know, you're real low, and maybe they don't trust it as much. It's a psychological thing. So what I would do with my chips in this case, when I'm down to one string of chips, he's got one string there on the left side of his screen, and is I would take those down completely and put them in a box or stack them on top of the cart or put them next to me and just offer chips with the combo meal. I wouldn't hang them because it doesn't, the appeal isn't the same. So when you have three or four hanging from your umbrella, looks great when they're all filled up. When you have one, doesn't look good at all. So I would remove that part.
Nachos, offer chili cheese nachos. I get the big bag at Sam's, and then I separate them into the individual portions so that they fit these to-go containers for the nachos. All right, so I've got two types of buns. Today I've got the Wonder brat buns. I normally get the ballpark brat, tailgater brat buns. And then I like these Pepperidge Farm top split buns. They work really good for the Dawgz. In the front here, this is my extra condiment cooler, so I have more condiments. I know I've got handmade signs. I'm working on getting some stickers, you know, decals to put around the cart. That's just going to have to wait financially.
Now, I want to tell you something right here, and he's fixing to tell you how long he's been in business. But I want you to look at something. If he couldn't afford signs, he made signs, which I teach, to make your signs. It doesn't matter. It always looks really sexy to have nice, expensive, you know, swooper flags and banners, and they're not that expensive. You can go get a banner for, you know, $49 or something. Do try to make that a priority, because that's your marketing, that's your draw. Don't think, oh, I'm gonna go to the movies tonight because I made, you know, $200 on the cart instead of buying banners. I'd buy the banners, and tomorrow you can make $400 on the cart. And that's how I would look at that. But his signs do look nice and clean. They're not like rain soaked and faded. They look really great. I will get to your questions. I apologize. I'm not ignoring them. I just want to let you know I will get to them. And you're fixing to see the prices, by the way, on the combo meals and stuff.
Because I'm just getting started. I've only been doing this for about a month and a half maybe now. All right. About 2 weeks ago, on the 15th, I got my first on-site inspection here in North Carolina, in Wake County. And the reason I got a 90...
Now, and I'll tell you, Wake County is very strict. That covers Raleigh area. And Wake County has a couple inspectors that are horrid. And even with that 98.5, and he's going to explain why he got a 98.5 instead of 100, which I never got 100.
0.5, it was two reasons. Number one, when he tested my sanitizer water, I didn't have quite enough bleach in it. So what I've done is I put less water in it now, and I put two caps of bleach in it. So,
okay, now let me explain this real quick, because I get questions on this quite often. The sanitized solution is required in all states. It's so you can wipe up stuff. They want bleach, a bleach mixture with water. Typically, it's two capfuls of bleach into a gallon of water. His inspector showed up, and he didn't have... when they tested it with like a pool test strip, it didn't show up enough. That is common if you're out in the hot sun, which Raleigh is hot this time of year, and a Raleigh area. And so they tested it. Well, it dissipates. Chlorine dissipates out of the water. So what I suggest you do is keep your gallon or half gallon of water there with the rag in it, but add a little extra bleach, okay? And that way, as it dissipates, you'll never fall below the recommended level by the health department. But it's not a big, big deal. It's not like they said, hey, you got to close up now. They didn't do anything like that, and they wouldn't. They would say, hey, I'm going to mark you off a point because of this, or a half a point.
If it's not strong enough now, then I don't know what to do. I went overboard just so I don't have that problem anymore. And then the other reason I lost points was because I had my personal soda instead of it down here, you know, the soda I'm drinking. I had it sitting up here when he pulled up and he saw it.
Now, I love this. He's so honest. And he says, hey, I lost a half a point because my soda was on top where people, where the food service area is. And they don't want it on top. They typically don't want your bleach bucket on top either. Not that it's unsafe. It could be, you know, if it spilled into the food and contaminated the food. So you always want to put your bleach bucket on the ground or on a table next to you, under the cart, something like that. Always be wiping down. If you get a break, wipe down with that bleach rag. When I say bleach rag, it's, you know, it's diluted down, but that's the point.
So he took a half point off. So make sure you, I don't know what state you're in, what the rules are for that. Just to be safe, put your soda down on the wheel well. So it's out of the way and all away from the food is the main reason. All right, so here's my menu. Did you see?
Now, I paused it here real quick just so you can get a good look. That's his menu.
I have a lot of toppings. I like to offer a lot of variety. And because North Carolina, I've got the Carolina Reds, and then the Bright Leaf smoked sausage. And then I have two types of bratwurst. I got the Johnsonville, the regular smoked brats, as well as the cheddar cheese brats, which is really good. It's got the cheese infused inside. And then the dogs I use are the Nathan's.
Now, before I move on, he's going to show you the dogs and stuff on the cart. And I want to point out something, and this is a common mistake. It's a sign of a good business mind, but it's a common mistake, because even though a good business mind can make a rational decision that isn't for their best interest. You just heard a minute ago, couldn't afford banners and swooper flags yet, which will bring him more business immediately. Can't afford that yet. Been in business about 5-6 weeks now and can't afford it. And I will put my money on the fact, because I know he's doing good in business. It's because he's carrying so many things which cost more money, which end up making you less money. Because you have all these things, so you end up with the risk of more waste and more losses. So my biggest critique out of this whole thing is nothing about his Carter setup, really. It's about the way he's chosen to do business right here. And it's a common mistake. I've done it. Thousands of vendors do it when they first get started, is they try to be too much to too many. And so what I would do is go with the red hot dogs, because he's in a county where that is a thing. Red dyed hot dogs. They are bright red. I kid you not. That is a thing in North Carolina. There's a manufacturer there that makes these red hot dogs, red hots, and people love them. So it tastes like a normal dog, but just red. So the bottom line is you will, if he culled his menu down to 2 to 3 different dogs, or 2 dogs and a sausage, or 1 dog and 1 sausage. That's what I would suggest. 1 dog, 1 sausage, and then my chips and stuff. If there's something specialty that he needs to carry, great, carry that. But having all that stuff on the menu, let's go back real quick. Look at this. He's got a cheddar cheese bratwurst, smoked sausage. He's got a beef bratwurst. He's got the Carolina red dog, the regular dog, and an all beef dog. Now, that's how many? That's 5 freaking main entree dogs. Slows you down immediately, harder to get set up, harder to take down, and your risk of loss is higher because you have everything out there and you're fixing to see his whole thing when he opens the pans. And you go, oh my gosh, what if it started raining and he had to go home? Now he's got a what with these dogs? Now I talk about ways you can use that those leftovers as a benefit and as a marketing thing. But you don't want to be doing that every day. He needs banners. He needs signs. And this is how he would get them. So let's go back. He's going to walk us to
good. It's got the cheese infused inside. And then the dogs I use are the Nathan's hot dogs, which I've been told I use the Member's Mark from the Sam's Club, which I've been told are Nathan's hot dogs. But anyway, in the front here is my condiment caddy. Mustard, ketchup, spicy mustard, gloves, aluminum foil. This is chili and cheese on this side. This one I've got the all beef dogs and the bright leaf smoked sausages. See how fat those fuckers are? Sorry. In the middle, I don't have anything right now, but this is where I normally would have the chili with beans, because I do a chili bowl. And sometimes I'll throw in some barbecue every now and then and do a barbecue sandwich. We're not supposed to have barbecue on the cart here in North Carolina, but I still do it every now and then.
Now I'm going to pause right there just for a second. North Carolina has a cool loophole that allows you to serve barbecue on a cart as long as it's a topping. They allow all kinds of things as toppings, but it can't be the main course. You can't serve a barbecue sandwich from an open cart, but you can have barbecue loaded hot dogs. Or there's a Blue Million toppings, but the bottom line is, so it's something he can do. Now, his health inspector may say no, but as far as code goes, he's allowed to carry the toppings he wants as long as they're kept at the right temp and stuff like that. I'll finish and let him.
All right, this side I've got the chicken dogs. This is the chicken pork mix dogs. And then these are the regular smoked brats. And then on the end, got the Carolina Reds. And these are those cheddar cheese brats from Johnsonville. They're so good. All right. I think that's pretty much everything.
Now, I will tell you this. If I wanted to serve other things, I would do it like Corey Lawrence does. I would have a special. Every Thursday would be my cheddar cheese brats with mac and cheese on top or something. I would not, or the pulled pork. I would not have that every day. And then I would reduce my risk. I would create people that followed me because, hey, on Thursdays, Ben Hillbilly Hot Dog's going to have this, and I'm going to be there Thursday. I don't care where he is. And that's the mentality people get. Instead of risking it all, you just saw Mike posted up, less is more. People want easy to read, easy to follow, easy to choose. That's correct. Jay just said, totally correct, Ben. The menu is too big for a hot dog cart. Less is more. Do combo meals, banners, pictures sell, and will make you money. Yes, pictures sell great. As far as having pictures of your menu items, those are fantastic ideas. Plus, you want, and you've heard me say this a blue million times, you want big signs that tell people what you have from a distance. Because even though you know it's a hot dog cart, there's many people that have never seen one except for in a movie. And they have no idea what this contraption is you have. And a lot of people are intimidated to come up to you and go, what do you got going there? Or get close enough to read a sign. It's better to have hot dog value meal, $9 or whatever on a big sign. All beef dogs, $4, whatever it is. So you want to do those kinds of things. Let's see. Jay mentioned they also want to use test strips to test your water. What he's saying is that you're required in all states to have your own test strips on standby for you to test your water, because they want to know that you're testing it to make sure that the chlorine hasn't dissipated out of it, that you're actually using something that kills germs. And they also want to be able to use your strips when they come test you. They don't carry their own strips. They do, but they don't tell you they do. Okay, so let me go here.
So if anybody ever has any questions or anything, you know, they're welcome to contact me. Like I said, I'm still kind of new. But I want to thank Ben and at Ben's Carts and everybody at Vendors United for all the help and advice. Without you guys, I wouldn't have been able to get this going as fast as I did. I kind of got forced into it before I was really ready because I got laid off from my other job because of all the COVID-19 crap going on. I bought this cart used about 6 months ago. I had to get this flip top from Ben because this cart came with those plexiglass sneeze guards, and that's required in North Carolina. And it was all melted and crappy looking, and I threw it away.
Okay, so he got a flip top from us, and that's that metal contraption you see. But I will tell you this, it's set up wrong. I've never seen it set up this way, and there may be something to do with his cart that he had to do it this way. A typical flip top covers about a steam table and 5/8 of a steam table, so almost two full steam tables, which is the typical size. It's about 39 inches across, okay, and 12 inches deep. And these are made, the way we've designed these is they go before your pans. And then your pans weigh that part down. And the way he's got his set up, he's got it set up on top of the pans. You shouldn't need to do that. But he may have a situation, I don't know specifically, where he had to do it this way. But if not, then he'll know now how to do it the right way.
This ordered this stainless steel flip top. Even though this is not a Ben's cart, it still fit pretty good. It hangs off a little bit on the ends. But that works out pretty good because it vents more to heat.
See, it only would hang off on the end if it's on wrong. Because he's got the same size steam table, so all he needs to do is pull his pans out, put that down, then set the pans in it, and then the lid still opens and closes, does the half lid. It works great. It makes a shelf for you.
Away from, you know, my face when I'm opening up the lids and stuff. And then I also wanted to add a grill to the side, which I'm going to have to do later on and then run it back through inspection. They're just going to have to wait for now. But there you go. Y'all have a great day and stay safe. Wash your hands.
Now, that's something probably his own inspector told him that he had to do. Probably told him that, hey, if you add any other equipment, you got to let us know. I would never tell a health inspector, hey, I'm adding a piece of equipment. Do you think a restaurant gets a new fridge and calls the inspector, or gets new deep fryers and calls the inspector? Hell to the no, they don't. So there's no reason he would have to do it. They're not going to come and shut him down. They may say, we needed to know about this. Duh. Who cares? Add the other equipment. A grill is allowed in North Carolina. Add the freaking grill and move on. They'll probably never even notice that it wasn't there to begin with. So just move on. That's what I would do. I really want to thank, him for sharing this. I think it's awesome. A lot of people are scared for me to see their video, or not for me to see it, for me to share it. I always ask, because I want to share it with everyone, but some people don't want it. You know, they may go, oh, Ben's going to critique this, and I could have made these mistakes. But everybody gets better by pointing out the mistakes in a nice way. It's not like I'm going, you freaking idiot. You should have had barbecue chips. You know, it's not like that. The Justin Mack, if you want to, I'd love to see your video of your setup. Here's two ways to do that. Sometimes it will go right through email. Another way, an easy way, is just to create you a YouTube account, even if it's set to private, and just load it up to YouTube and then give me the link. And I can download that from there. Or you can send it to Dropbox or use Google Drive and email me the link there. I'd love to have the videos because it helps other people and everybody comes out ahead. Steve V in the house. Good to see you, brother, up there in Minnesota. So. I appreciate it. I hope y'all have a wonderful day. I hope you kick butt this week in vending. If you're new to vending and, or if you, you know, have been dreaming of this forever, I have a free website that has tons of information. In fact, there's nothing that I sell that isn't already free there. Okay. It just requires you looking and reading and watching videos. And, you know, some of me bores you to tears, but it's learnhotdogs.com. Okay. And if you'll go to learnhotdogs.com, you'll get a wealth of information. Now, if you're ready to get in and you're like, man, I want to learn from the best. I want the best. I want to surround myself with the smartest, greatest, the brightest, the bestest vendors in the world. Then join Vendors United. You can jump in for free, try it out, see what you think. And And if you like it, stay. It will give you access to over 500 vendors who are on there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. There's vendors in there helping each other. Because even the best vendors, we just had a show Monday night, okay, last night, 9 p.m. We do one on Mondays and Thursdays. And it's a private VU meeting. And there was a bunch of vendors in there. And one of the vendors pointed out that no matter what, still he learns every time something. And he's been vending years. So we all do. We all learn new stuff. So Alexander, Marshall, I'll send some pictures, videos soon. We have been crazy busy here in Washington out of 200 hot dogs in 3 hours. Okay. Now see that, folks? I'm telling you, once you go hot dog, you never go back. Okay. That should be like a saying. I wish it rhymed. Anyway, it would be freaking the most power and the most bestest, greatest feeling in the world is to have independence, freedom, not making somebody else rich, making yourself rich or making yourself comfortable. We have vendors like Mark Lawler, Great American Hot Dog Stand. He could make 4 times as much, but he likes his life the way it is. So he vends 2 or 3 days a week. That's it. 2 hours a day. And he makes a great living and he likes it that way. That's the power. You can't tell your boss, hey, I just only want to work like 2 hours a day. And really that's about it. But I want you to pay me enough that I can survive off that. This is where it's at. There's more freedom. And I'll tell you again and again and again, I'm going to keep tooting this horn till everybody says, shut up, Ben. I'm already making enough money. I don't need to hear it anymore. Is that this is the best time to get in. Because it is incredible. Whether you want to start with lemonade, we had 2 new vendors start with lemonade this past weekend. It was phenomenal, their numbers. One did over 1,100. The other one did 300 and something. I don't remember the exact number. 300 and something cups of lemonade on Saturday. Brand new. Both of them had never done it. All they did is took my free course. So you can go to learnhotdogs.com/lemon, or you can just go howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. That's a long domain name, right? How to start a lemonade business.com and grab that information and go out there and do it. You just saw Ken Packer in here. He owns Packer's Lemonade. He's bottling it now because he's selling it faster than he can make it. So he's got bottles of it at the cart that he's already made up. And people are buying it and taking it. So you're going to love this business and the freedom it gives and the money that it gives. And it gives you, it empowers you. It empowers the fact that you're able to help other people. I like that. Jay makes a great point. It's about the naysayers. And I'm sure Jay's heard my naysayer rant. Jay says, just do it. Don't overanalyze or listen to your negative relatives. Just do it. Jay right now is facing one of the hardest challenges of any vendor I've seen with red tape. Okay. And just an incredible amount of red tape. And he just bulldozes through it because he knows once it's done, it's done. It's free selling then, but he's doing it. He's not like, oh, I can't do that. That's going to take more than 30 minutes of my time. I ain't got this freedom and independence just ain't worth it to me. No, he's bullheaded and going to do it. And he's doing it the right way. There's a couple questions I know I missed. Okay. One being, how much was the combo meals? He doesn't have any. You saw the menu, right? Where's his combo meal? A lot of vendors choose not to do combo meals. I'm okay with that because it's a matter of personal opinion. Would I recommend you do it? Absolutely. I would have at least one combo meal. That's what I always had, one combo meal. In the beginning of the video, Donald, he tells exactly city, town, every down to the county where he is. But he's in North Carolina. Somebody asked about South Carolina. South Carolina is a state that blows my mind sometimes. Depends on where you are in South Carolina. But South Carolina is not the end of the world to get started. Okay, but it's just a process, you know, red tape. I teach you how to do it at free at learnhotdogs.com, but there's a couple like Summersville, Okay. I call it Summervillistan because they had a inspector there that was a nightmare and tried to keep you out of there. They had city officials that tried to keep you out of there until we took them to task over it and showed them that they were violating federal law. Then they changed. I wrote a whole article called something about we don't want capitalism in Summervillistan. So Jay says combo meals on a picture banner sells the most for me. See, look, Steve says we do street menu combos, but no combos for the brew halls. He's talking about the brew halls and up in Minnesota. That's a northern word, I think, because we don't call them that here. But y'all know what I'm talking about, I hope. He goes to the brew halls and does these. They're almost like private catering gigs, but he's vending there and does a killer job, but he doesn't do the combos there. So it depends on your demographic, you know, the people for that area. Your customers you're going to be serving at that location will determine what you need to do differently. Like when my friend Jason Brown would go to a winery and set up and do these fancy crocodile and rattlesnake sausages and hot dogs to pair with different wines and charge $18 for an 8-inch hot dog. Then he didn't have no combo meal. This wasn't a McDonald's. This was high end food. But then if he was vending in front of Tractor Supply, he had a combo. Okay. So that's the point. Anyway, I hope you have a fantastic week. I hope you do. I want to tell you this, and I said this last night at the beginning of our Vendors United meeting. Ignore all the crap you are hearing. Stay the hell away from all the news feeds on Facebook and the people ranting about this or that, because here's the deal. You can do nothing about it. Here's where you can help. Be the best person you can be. Be kind to others. Love one another as best you can. Okay? I didn't say love everybody. I just said love one another as best you can, and focus on the things you can change. Focus on the things that make a difference in life. Focus on the things that you can have a positive effect in. But you or I ranting about how Trump did this, or Trump is the best president, or and these people suck and these people don't suck, doesn't help nobody and just makes for a pile of mess in your head and gets you depressed and gets you stirred up over nothing. So focus on the things that you can control and leave the rest be. Okay. Pray for them maybe, but I just leave them alone. Just leave them alone. Cause I can't change them. Anyway, I love you and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.